Do I have everything? I think so. It was a lot that I hauled in October, for sure.
When did the alien battle come in? I'll order the supplies, so I need to have it as well. Yes, like this.
Do I have everything now? I hope so. So we can get into it.
Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, I'm confused. That's not weird though. If you are new, my name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent, and I'm often confused. I also tend to ramble and I am sarcastic and I'm just going to say it. I'm weird. Why? Because I'm too poor to be eccentric. If that vibes with your vibe, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button because I upload, well, face it, it's December. I upload quite a lot. Well, I usually upload quite a lot because I have so many ideas. Today, however, is basically a bite-sized review of the stuff that I hauled in the month of October. I will link my October haul underneath the cards and in the description box, and I will also list the now, the products that I'm going to talk about today will be there as well. Basically, it's a copy-paste of my October haul description box, which is so fun. What I have on the eyes, though, is I don't know if it is up. I don't think so, but it is coming. It is basically let the Wheel of Fortune pick my eyeshadow palette. So I'm going to not tell you what is on my eyeballs, because if you want to know, watch that video. I'm basically self-promoting here. Can you tell? For the rest, what I have on this cutesy, let me zoom out a little bit more so you can see it better. Look how cutesy these ears are. It's actually for a child because I have a very tiny head. So yeah, these are from Taco from last year's Christmas collection. The sweater is from Decathlon. The nails are from a dollar store. The rings are from all over the place. And these are from AliExpress. That's I think, very, very quickly what I have. Yes, let's just get into it. So let's start with PR first and then go to gifts. I think that's it. What was the, where's my, oh Lord. So the first thing that I got in PR, well, actually, I think the only thing that I got in PR that month is it? Yeah, I think so, is the Autumn palette from 5050 Makeup. Let me show you what she looks like. This is what she looks like. I freaking love this palette with all my heart. It is one of my favorites in the collection. That video I am also going to film. It's on my filming schedule, my favorites of this year. So you will probably see this one again. I've also got a discount code with them. It will be listed down in the description box. I'm going to go over this pretty quickly because I have done a bunch of videos with the palette. I love the palette. Yes. So let's go to what was gifted to me next. Then the first thing that I got this month, which was such a surprise, was a custom made palette by one of you from We Cosmetics. Here is the color story. I have done a video with it and I really like the quality. I have played with it in my off time as well. I really do like it. And the color story that she selected is just so me in a palette. Thank you so, so much. It's just, yeah, if you are wondering about We Cosmetics, I think it is worth it. And can I just say, the lip plumper that I ordered, which is technically from last month, I really do like it. It's sold out though, but I really do like it. That was We Cosmetics. Next, I got a big box, or that was at the end of the month. I got a very big box also from one of you. I have not used a lot out of that box. So basically, I'm just going to tell you about the things that I did use and how I feel about them. I have used the e.l.f. Puff Puff Primer. I prefer it as a moisturizer because it is too much like a moisturizer for my liking in a primer. So it is downstairs in my skincare pile, so I can use it as a moisturizer if I want to. So yeah, then what I did use and can give you my opinion on are these two from Charlotte Tilbury. Now here is the blush in A Walk of No Shame and the glosses in the same color. So here is the blush. I don't have it on today, but I really, really do like this. I think it is gorgeous. It stays on for a very, very long time. I love the formula. I like the whole aesthetic of it. I just still think that 40 bucks is overpriced, but that is maybe me. I'm cheap as bougie. Yes. Then let's go to the gloss. I like the gloss. It is a plumping gloss, but it is a slight plumping gloss, so it is a little bit minty. I like the color. The only thing I find weird, though, is the applicator. It is a heart-shaped thingamajingy. Can you see that? I hope so. It's It does not really pick up a lot of product, and I kind of need to... Did you hear that? Yeah, I like the gloss. I just wish it had a normal applicator. I think that is basically it. I don't know what this retails for originally. I don't think I would have paid it. But I got it as a present, and I'm very, very glad that I did. So thank you so, so much. I do have to say, though, that this does make me want to try more from Charlotte Tilbury on sale. I'm going to say that again. Yeah, as well. Because I have a very hard time paying prices like that for makeup. Because, yeah, if you are new, I am more of a drugstore priced person. And not that I don't think that some makeup is worth it, but especially now, the products in the drugstore are so, so good that sometimes I don't think that higher priced brands can almost warrant being so expensive. Does that make any sense? So yeah, the next thing that she sent me that I have tried extensively is a Becca highlighter in the shade Own Your Light, and it is basically what you see here. That is what it does on my cheeks, and it is so, so pretty. I like this a lot. I like this as a highlight. I like this as a blush topper. I like it as an inner corner highlight. I just think it is very, very, very pretty. So thank you so, so much for sending them. It also makes me want to try more Becca highlighters. And I'm actually eyeing the little minis. I also love the whole aesthetic of this. I really want to try more from both Becca and Charlotte Tilbury. So yeah, thank you for sending it, and kind of darn you as well. It's going to cost me money. Yeah. So that was what was gifted to me, I believe. What I have used. So yeah, let's next go to the things that I paid for then. Let's start with Colourpop, because that's the first on my list. So I have 3 palettes from Colourpop. Well, I technically hauled 4 palettes that month, but the child palette came in November. So I'm going to talk about that in the November bite size review thingamajing. Yes, let's start with these two, the Smoke Show and the Taupe. Let's start with the Taupe. I haven't used it a lot, but I do really like it. I like the quality of this. I like the quality of this. I like the colors of this. I like it. It's my kind of neutral. That's also a video I want to do. My kind of neutral palettes from a colorful lover standpoint. So let me know if you are interested in that. And I do really like this. I think it's very, very pretty. I haven't played with it a ton, though. I do think it's worth it, yeah. Okay, so the Blow and Smoke by Colourpop. I haven't used it yet. I just haven't gotten around to it. So yeah, I cannot tell you about it. I do really want to create basically a gray silver smoky eye, and then with a red lower lash, because I think that's very, very pretty. Or maybe even a bright yellow. So I do want to play with it. It is in my you need to play with it pile. So I do want to, I just haven't yet. So I cannot tell you anything about it. Okay, let's next go to... Oh yeah, the Shroud Betty Jean is not in yet. Then we go to I Heart Revolution, the green squishy eyeball. I bought this purely for the packaging and the fact that I now have all 3 squishy eyeballs, because everyone needs a squishy eyeball. I just wanted the complete collection, and look how cute. It is a squishy eyeball. Everyone needs one. At least I think so. So yeah. I also bought a bunch of stuff from Catrice. Yeah, so this was a Boozy Shop order. I got this one, the True Skin Concealer in the shade Cool Rose. Yes. I use this every single day. I really, really like this concealer a lot. It is nice full coverage. It is not as thin as the One Drop coverage from... Catrice, but I really do like this, and this kind of sets itself as well. So yeah, unless my under eyes are basically overly hydrated, you know, that I put a little bit too much cream before I went and did my makeup. If I don't have that and my cream has sunken in, I usually don't need to set this, at least now in winter. I really, really like it. And then I got these, the 5-in-1 palettes. I've done a video with this. My opinion hasn't changed. These are amazeballs. If you see these, they are so, so worth it. I really, really hope that Catrice will make more of these. They are bomb.com. They are very, very good. So yeah, let's next go to these, the 5-in-1 lip balms. I have them all. They are very, very nice, very comfortable, and they all have a tint to them. I am still planning on doing a lip swatch video. I just haven't gotten around to it just yet, but they are very, very nice. Let's see, what else? Yeah, the eye primer. I almost forgot this, the eyeshadow primer. I really like this one. It has a doe foot. As you can see, it is a very thin consistency, so I also love to use specifically this one if I am going to do kind of a cut crease effect. So I don't use a concealer for that. I use an eye primer because usually the consistency is thinner and it is not as wet as a concealer is. And this one is perfect for me because the consistency is light and it stays sticky for quite some time. So I have the time to pack on a matte eyeshadow if I want to. And yeah, that's basically it. I like it. I like it a lot. I do have to say though that if you have eyeshadows that are maybe a little bit more difficult to blend out, you need to set this one, at least where you want to blend, because for me at least it stays sticky for a very, very long time, which is good if you have shadows that have a problem layering, because the base kind of offsets that because it is so sticky. I kind of hope that makes sense, but I know that if you have an eyeshadow formula that has less binders in them, so it's maybe a little bit drier, and you want to build them on top of each other, sometimes it's very difficult because they don't want to grip each other, then you need a base that is more sticky than a base that is a little bit less sticky. That's how I'm going to explain it today, and I hope that you understand. Otherwise, ask in the comment section and I hope that I have a better answer for you. yes, was that... yeah, next I have written down Max and the Max and More stuff that I hold. I did a video with this and it went online as well, so I will link it. I had some hits and I had some misses. So let's start with the eyeshadow palette, because that's the first one that I wrote down here. This is very, very good quality, guys. This retails for €3.50 or something like that. It's just insane. And the quality, it blew me away. For that amount of money, this is worth a lot more. The shadows stayed on all day as well. The shadows blended nicely, they layered nicely, and the base that I used was also from the brand Max & More, and that is a base that dries down very quickly. And it felt a little bit more like an eye cream, so not my preferred eye base, but maybe it is yours. It dried down quickly. Did I already say that? I think I did, so you don't need to set that. And this palette performs beautifully on top of that. So definitely, if you have an action and you can get a hold of Max & More products, this one is definitely a contender. Now, I already mentioned the eye base. I don't know where I left it. It's just a blue tube. Did I put it in the eye base drawer? Oh, I put it in the eye base drawer. This is what she looks like. As I said, it's just a blue tube. It's nice. As I already said, it is more along the lines of an eye cream, but then a very thin consistency and it dries down. So yeah, bronze and highlight duo. Yeah, you know, I did like the formula, but it is so light for me. It's just very, very light. I don't think that I can use this in the depths of winter, even, because then I still think it is too light for me. If you are fair though, I think you will get along with this. And this is in the shade Goddess Glow. Now, I do know that their shade range is different from what I can get in the stores, and it's a little bit wonky. Sometimes they have more colors than other times. If I look on the site from Action, it's not, they don't even list this one, but we do have it in store, so it's kind of weird. So you just need to check if there is a darker one than Goddess Glow, because this one is too light, and I'm just going to pass it along. But it is a nice formula. Then I also had, oh yeah, the eye pencils. They are makeup pencils and you can use them for eyes and lips. They are very nice and creamy. They work beautifully as a lip liner. As an eye pencil, they work very nicely as well. However, they don't stay as long in the waterline as, for instance, I don't know, my Catrice pencils stay for a very, very long time. LA Girl, Kiko Milano, those stay on for a very long time because they are basically waterproof. And these aren't really, but they are very, very nice and creamy. So there is that. And basically, I paid €1.99 or say €2 for 10. So Who's complaining, you know? Okay, then the brow pencil. I have it somewhere. I don't know where. It's too warm for me. The texture was okay. It was a little bit more soft and creamy than I like, but it was okay. But the color was too warm. Lip pencils. The lip pencils are very, very nice, actually. I have them here. They are twist-up pencils. They are very nice and creamy. They don't stay on as long as the ones that I have from Catrice, for instance, but they are very, very nice. I don't remember. I think it was 77. Cents per pencil, something like that. Then the lippy, I like it. I have the shade Creme Brulee. I really do like it. They say that it is a matte, but it is more of a satin for me. It's nice and creamy, hydrating. It's a beautiful color. Definitely worth it if you see them. And we also have the blush in Dusty Rose. It's a pretty color. It's very, very light for me though. And I saw on the site that they also have a coral one, I think. And I did not see that one, I think, because that is a shade that I do really like. So maybe I will grab that shade as well. This is a very nice shade. I need to build it up though. If you are fair, you will like this. If you are darker than me, basically medium, you will not see it. Yes, but the formula is very nice. Then the contour stick. I really, really like this contour stick. Now I have the shade medium and there is also a dark. Well, it's color-wise between my Kiko Milano one and my... La Ritzy one, so it is a medium tone for me. It's nice, it's a little bit red based, but it is a nice formula. So yeah, it blends very well. So I have used this one quite a bit actually. Okay. Next, we have the Kiko Milano. I just mentioned this one. This is a very nice sculpting stick. Now this is in the shade 200. They had one that was a bit darker. This is not a contour stick. It's too warm to be a contour stick. I have it actually on today. I really like it. I like the formula as well. I think I want the darker one of this too. But I need to check in store how much of a color difference there is first. I like the formula of this a lot. Then we have the brush that I got. The brush number 51. Yeah, it's a nice brush. I can use it to... I use it for my glitter primer. And you can also use it to blend out your... concealer if you want to. Yes, okay. Next, a VE Cosmetics palette for the recently deceased and a lippy. So the palette I did a video with, let me just show you what she looks like. This is what she looks like. It's a very nice rainbow palette and I just love the whole vibe of this. You know, this is a rainbow palette that I want to use because it is just my aesthetic. Here's the front. I just love it so, so much. VE Cosmetics is a UK-based indie brand. Their quality is definitely, definitely worth checking out. I have a bunch of palettes from them that you can... Can you see them there? Yes, there. I have a bunch of palettes and more will be coming in the future for sure. Okay, the next thing from VE was Black Hole. That's the shade name. It is a liquid moisture lipstick and it is my only black. I really, really like this. But it's a very nice, comfortable formula. And it's a very, very pretty black that I don't really have to build up because it's opaque enough. It's not streaky. I really, really like it. Then next from Beauty Bay. I got skincare from Beauty Bay. Board sheet oil. I have used that... ever since it was released by The Ordinary. I love the stuff. And I got a niacinamide serum. And I'm so happy that I got the niacinamide serum from The Ordinary again. Because it is just the best one that I have tried for me. Now maybe the texture isn't as nice as for instance the one from the Inky List. But I don't know. My skin just gets happy when I use that one from The Ordinary. So I have it again. That's all I can say about it. I do want to make another skincare video soon though. So... yeah, that's it. Let's go to these. The pastel liners from Beauty Bay. I have three shades. I just got one of the packs. I have a green, a blue and the purple in the pastel. When I swatch it, it's very nice. So swatching wise, they're very, very nice. But you do need to make sure that they are a little bit warmer for in the waterline. And you kind of need to go hem a little bit. But once they are on, they stay on for a very nice time. And yeah, that's basically all I can say. I do know that LA Girl recently launched pastel liners as well. I'm very curious about those. So maybe I will get some and I can compare them, you know? So yeah. Okay, let's next go to the Magic palette then that I have here. It's so pretty, guys. I think they still have it. I really, really like this. I like the color story a lot. I liked the quality as well. Yeah, I did a bunch of videos. Did I do an eye swatch video? No. I did do 5 looks though. And did I use it recently? I don't know. But this just makes me happy to look at. I just really, really like this one. I think it is a very, very good very good quality, especially for the price. Okay, let's start with the Essence foundation. I have used this a lot since I tried it in a video. I really, really like this one. It is... When I used this for the first time, I said it reminded me of the It's CC cream, and it does. However, this has less coverage. So this is a light to medium coverage that you can build, but you cannot get it more than medium. And the It's CC cream, I can build up more. I hope that makes sense. I really do like this foundation though. It's very, very pretty on the skin. It is not luminous, but it is... I don't know, almost a satin finish. I really, really like this. It's a little bit sticky. I don't have to set it, but it does stick very, very well to my skin. It works very well underneath a mask as well, and you can sheer it out. I really like it. That's all I can say. I have used it a ton. I do have to say, though, that if I have basically a bad skin day, I don't know, a lot of redness going on in my face, this does not really cover it because it is a maximum medium coverage, but it is... Yeah, very, very nice. I have the shade Neutral Honey. I think they have 35 shades of this. They have just a few in stores though. But yeah, if you can get it. I know that for us here, I got it at Boozy Shop. Boozy Shop sells it for, at least for the Netherlands. Cosmetic for Less sells it as well. But unfortunately, they don't ship to the US. They ship worldwide, but not to the US. I don't know really what that's about, but... Yeah, unfortunately they don't. But if you see this, I think it is very, very worth it. That was weird. Yes, I know. Okay, let's next go then to... Let's go to the palettes then. The Makeup Obsession Feeling Spicy and the Smoking palette. I have done a video with both. I really, really like these. I really like these. So here they are. Really, really... This one, the middle shade... Just for that one alone, I would buy this palette. It's just such a pretty... It's a teal with a purple and a red. It's so unique. And the quality is very, very nice as well. This one only has one true matte, which is the black. Then this is a satin. And this is a satin. No, yeah, and this is a satin. And the rest are basically shimmery, duochrome-y goodness. And the Feeling Spicy palette, yeah, it's very nice quality as well. And I think this can be a very nice everyday palette for you if you like this color story. I think they are definitely worth it. So yeah. Okay, let's next go to this, the NYX Sweet Cheeks blush in the shade Almost Famous. I love this. This is a bright orange blush. I love this formula a lot. It is a cream to powder. This is with a thing like that. And I paint it on my hand and then with a brush... I go in and then I stipple it on my face. That is how I use it because it's pretty pigmented. So you can go ham with it if you like to. And if you are vegan, you can go vegan ham with it. I don't know. The last thing that I got in that haul was this one from Kimchi, the Freckle Tint. Now, when I got this, I was more tan than I am now. And I compared this to the Lottie London one. And the Lottie London one then was too warm for my skin. I do really like it now though. Now I'm a lot paler than then. And I don't know. It just works with my skin tone better now. So when I am in my winter or in my summer color, which is more towards the medium aspect of things, I like the freck more. Because I feel like it is, I don't know, it's prettier. It's almost like the Lottie London one then is too light and too warm, and it makes my face look like I have a lot of red spots, post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, say that 10 times fast, in my face. This is a little bit more red than the Lottie London one. So actually, since I did the video with trying this, I haven't used it. But now that I like the Lottie London one, it works with my skin tone now. Maybe I need to try it. And I'm going to put it where I can see it so that I can try it and see if I like it. Now that I am paler. Okay. We also got the Mitchell Green Camo palette. That I ordered. I don't remember if it came in October or November, but it doesn't really matter. I have done a bunch of looks with this, a bunch of videos with this. I did an eye swatch video and review, and I did 5 looks. And there is a collab coming on Thursday with my good friend Uli from Makeup Monsterly. That's her channel name. It's also with this palette. I really, really like this palette. And I'm actually sad that I didn't got the other palette as well when they launched. I'm not going to get it now because there is so much weirdness going on with their site. I do hope that they get their shit together, because I know that a lot of people are not happy with how they are handling things. Now, they do have resellers, so if you want this and you don't want to buy from the brand site, there is a reseller in Germany. There is a reseller in Germany, and there are 2 in Australia, I believe. And then their own site. So yeah, that's basically it. I do think it is worth the price though. I really do like it. Okay, a lot. What else? I think I have 2 things left. Yeah, so this one, the Alien Cosmetics Serendipity. I ordered this in September, but it came in October. And I really, really like this one. Now, they have restocked it. And I have an affiliate code in case you want to use it. It is listed down in the description box. This is just such a pretty palette. This is so much a holiday palette for me, especially without the yellow. It's just so, so pretty. And I am planning to do a nice Christmassy look with this. I really, really like it. And I love the artwork as well. I just really like it. It was my first time trying Alien Cosmetics. And I am in love. So yeah. Then the last thing I'm going to talk about is this little bad boy. It is the Lavender Chinchilla from Sigil, inspired by Tammy Tanuka. Look at the outside. The packaging is so, so very sleek. Now, the names are on the back and they are numbers. The shades are sold individually as well. And I will link where you can find the palette. I love this palette a lot. I have done a video with this. I have since used it. I have used it a ton. I really, really like this one. I like this one so much that I have also ordered her first palette in this format, which was a neutral palette, the Golden Dragon, I believe it is called, which is a neutral palette. I have ordered the same size as this one, and then she came out with another palette which contained 10 shades in a few formats. So she has a big format, these types of pens, then she has one that's smaller, that's micro size. I ordered the micro size because the layout was better for me, and she has also that palette split into 2. In case you were wondering, I will leave where you can find it down below. But I ordered those 2 as well. I just think this is a very, very, very pretty color story. Very unique color story to my collection. The shadows blended like a dream, especially the mattes, which is very unique because they are very gray. And very gray, cool-toned shadows can go patchy so, so quickly. And this one doesn't. It's just a very, very nice quality. Definitely worth checking out. And I think that is it for today's video. It was a long one, wasn't it? But yeah, I hauled a lot as well. Did I cover everything? I think I did. Yes, I think I did. And that is then going to be it for today's video. Let me go to the side to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen. And if you want to become a member, there is a link to join down in the description box. Before you leave, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up, hit the subscription button if you haven't done so already, and then the bell button so you will be notified of my next upload, which will be, who am I kidding, probably tomorrow, you know, December and all that. And yeah, leave me a comment down below as well, because it helps me out tremendously. Let me know if you have any of these goodies. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section as well. For now, this is going to be it. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you, as I said, very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.